Hello and thanks for watching Gary Teaches Maths. I'm continuing to go through the Edexcel higher tier paper from June 2018. And this is paper three. So this is a question about using sine rule and cosine rule. What we're asked to do is we're asked to find the length AD in this second triangle here. So in order to do that, first of all, we would need to find the length of this one here. Because in triangle ABD, we haven't yet got enough information to find length of AD, which I'm just going to write as Y there to distinguish from the X I've already got. So we're going to need to turn our attention, first of all, to the triangle, which is BCD. So we can see, if I just draw a quick sketch of it again here, we can see that what we've got 109, we've got 34, so we're given two of the angles. We're looking for this one here, and we're given this length. So this is a question which we're going to use the sine rule for, and one of the reasons we're choosing the sine rule is we've got opposite pairs of side and angle. So we can see we've got another opposite pair where we've got the angle here, 109 and 12.5. And if I write down the sine rule, what it is that it's A over sine A equals B over sine B. So if we had a standard triangle, which we labelled A and then B, C, where the letters are actually the opposite ones for the side. So if I've got B uppercase, that represents an angle. And then the side that's opposite it has got the same letter, but the lowercase version of it. So the side opposite the C there would be lowercase c. The side opposite A would be lowercase a. So if the sine rule is written in this format, we can also say we've got C over sine C. We can see what we've got is we've got a length on the top of the fraction there. And we've got the angle A underneath it. So if we decide to call this side A, this would be angle A in our formula. And I'm going to call this side B. And so this is going to be angle B. So if I just put it into the first bit of it here, we don't need to ever use three fractions in a row. It's just showing that all these ratios are equal. So I can say, right, x, as I've got there, over the sine of the opposite angle, sine 34, is going to equal the 12.5 that we have here over the sine of the opposite angle there. So it's 12.5 over sine 109. And if we could rearrange that, we could get this sine 34 over to the other side by multiplying both sides by sine 34. So that would give me that x is equal to 12.5 sine 34 over sine 109. And if I put all that into my calculator, what I will get is 7.39267 and then a few more places after that. And it's important when you're doing this question, because we're trying to find the answer, the final answer to three significant figures, we need to make sure we're working much more accurately than that in the run-up to the final answer. So we can't round up this currently to three significant figures. We have to use all the figures on the calculator is the safest bet. And to do that, we can always use the answer button on the calculator, which saves us having to type it all in one go. So having got X now, we're going to look at our triangle ABD. Again, what I'll do, I'll just draw that here. So there we go. ABD. And I'm going to say we're looking for this one, which is the length AD. So I've denoted that as Y. And we've just found the value of X. So that would be 7.392 with all the remaining figures of the on the calculator display as well. And this side is 11.4. And we have 86 degrees is the angle there. So for this one, we're going to use the cosine rule. And I'm just going to draw as a standard triangle again. So if we have a standard triangle, so as I said before, if the angles are denoted as uppercase, then the sides are the lowercase of the same letter. So the opposite A is lowercase A, opposite to B is lowercase B, and opposite to C is lowercase C. So the formula for when we're looking for a length is that A squared equals B squared plus C squared, which looks a lot like Pythagoras, but so it is Pythagoras with a bit added on, minus 2 times B times C, and then times by cosine of angle A there, cos A. So that's the general format of that. So what I'm going to do is attempt to put this into the formula. Now, although this is labeled A, B, D, which can be confusing because we might think then this A has to be the A that's put there, we can spin this triangle round so that A is whatever is most suitable for it to be. Now, if we look at what we're using, or what we're looking for, we actually want this Y. So that's what I'm going to choose as my A value in the formula. And so B and C can actually be either side. B and C can be, these two could be either way round. Okay, it's just important that this is my angle A as I'm putting it into the formula there. And then the one I'm looking for here is the Y. So I'm going to put Y into there. So if I substitute everything in, what I'll end up with is Y squared equals the 11.4 squared plus 7.392. Again, remembering to put all the decimal places in, squared minus 2. And then again, it's 11.4. times by the 7.39 with all the calculator button with all the decimal places on it, and then that has to be times by cosine of the angle, which is 86. Okay, that's all in one line there. I've just written it there to save space. So if I work that out, I can just put all that into the calculator in one go. If I work that out, then what I'll end up with is that y squared is equal to 172.85. And again, it will have a few decimal places at the end of it. And in order to find out what y is, then y is actually the square root of that. So because I can remove a square root by squaring both sides of the equation. And if I put that into my calculator using the answer button again so that I don't have to type all that in, what I'll end up with is 13.147, again with a few more decimal places. But the question is asking us to write it to three significant figures. So if I do that, that means actually cutting it off here. So first significant figure is the 1, second significant figure is the 3, third significant figure, again, is the 1 there. And what I need to do is look at the number after this final significant figure place to decide whether the 1 is going to stay as a 1 or if it's going to be put up to a 2. And the way we decide that is we look here, and because the number there is below 5, i.e. it's 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4, it means the 1 here will stay as it is. So to three significant figures, this is 13.1 and it's centimetres because we've been working in centimetres throughout the question. And that's it, we've done it. So I hope that's been helpful to you. If it has, please like our video and subscribe to our channel, which is Gary Teaches Maths. And for more help and articles and tuition about all things maths, then visit our website, which is bestmathstutors.co.uk. And it's just appearing in the corner of the screen there. Thanks for watching.